I was speaking with a friend that sells tea. He had made a business of importing tea from all over the world. He made such an interesting tea, such an interesting blend of tea, that soon he was selling certain chefs a single cup of his tea. Such an intensely aromatic and almost butterly matcha blend. He was selling it for $42 a cup to certain chefs in the city of New York. Tea, he told me, the tea ceremony is about being present to the person in front of you, communing with the other, me being present to you, us to each other, us to all eternity, because all of it is here, now with us. It got me to think about how the world discloses itself to us, to me. What did I mean by the world? Or better yet, how did I sense it? Sense, time, being, things, intimations, the space between things, the sun, the clouds, other people, the sea. What animates each of these things and our sense of them? And these things with us, within us, without us? Are you having a tea ceremony with life? Is life the ceremony? I was in Athens last summer, and myself and my family, my two kids, we lived on the edge of a hill. We were staying there, an Airbnb, of course, at the Philopappus Hill in the neighborhood of Petrolona. There is, for those of you who've been there recently to Athens, graffiti everywhere. And there is something about it that's, well, it's just perfect. It sets off a kind of degradation, in a sense, a city written on, something so present for a city that's so old, a signature of the now written, the now over the past. The hill of Philopappus is rocky, desert-like and sparse, and you walk and you walk and you walk and you walk, and that's something I just love to do when I travel, to walk, to get lost. Heading somewhere, nowhere, everywhere. Once you go outside, you're hit by this immense light, the startling light. On the hill, we walk under olive and pine trees, through ruins and rocks, and there's so many ruins in Greece. Some of them may simply have a sign or not. I mean, there's just, everything is sort of a ruin. Well, you walk in this smolder of heat, and it's sort of deliciously obscene. And we were 45 minutes away from the Acropolis, which we set out to see from our hill. And soon, from afar, there was this dazzling light on this plateau across from us. And there was thousands of little ant-like tourists crawling all about it. Yes, on a plinth of sorts, it seemed, was the whole encapsulation of what we think of as the beginning of Western history. These ordered columns, a sprawling edifice of propitiousness. What a word, propitiousness. It's what my friend was talking about in terms of the tea ceremony, to be present, to be aware, to be here, to listen, to be with the other, to commensurate with others, propitiously with nature, with existence, with ourselves. Looking on at the Acropolis, which stands on a shelf of sorts, on a plateau unto itself, you have this amazing view on the site around which, from the Peloponnese to the Greek islands, moving back and forward, 500 years from the Neolithic, the early fortress cities of Mycenae, Tyrin, Assini, to the huge networked classic imperium of Athens and the Athenian League to the fall. In roughly 1,000 years, in that 1,000 years, you get an amazing picture. Entire cosmologies live to the full and then overturn. religion and spirituality, the Neolithic, the Archaic, all well before the ancient, or what we call the classical. Sex, love, war, gods, enormous appetites. Sex, love, war, gods. This extraordinary luminous light. This light that fills you through and through. The Greeks take up the world in a very particular way.